Hello and welcome. Silreys here with Mech Warrior Online. So I have two drops here of some Jägermech S variant gameplay for you, featuring four ultra autocannon tools in those, you know, raised, elevated arms of the Jägermech. Because those arms are pretty dang high. Which means peeking with these things is pretty dang nice and easy. Essentially peeking over things, not necessarily around various corners and other obstacles, but over things allows you to shoot over things just fine. Now, this particular thing obviously does not, well, at this time, who knows what happens when the quirk passes come to be. But for now, at the time of this recording, the Jägermech S does not have any sort of ultra autocannon jam chance reduction quarks or anything of the sort to make this better for ultra tools. I am just frankly playing it with four ultra tools because I wanted to try that thing out on this particular mech. See if it is actually worth playing for any sort of, you know, extended time other than, hey, let's try this out and see if it functions. And I have to say, after the half a dozen or so games I played with it, it seems kind of okay. Not crazy good, not truly good or anything of the sort, just kind of okay. And yeah, this position I am playing here on Tourmaline here, I play that position because I really don't want to walk into the Valley of Death, but since basically half of the team went this way, I guess I'm going this way. Because being separated entirely from the team is probably more stupid of an idea than going into a bad position with the rest of the team. As a general thing. And especially if you are not very good at the game, and if you listen to me talk, I have never claimed to be good at this game. Never claimed to be very good or any good at this game. So, don't do things which you know, don't necessarily force you to be really, really good at the game, such as playing entirely alone. Typically, what I find is going down there through that, which I tend to call Valley of Death, just means that you are dead. However, in this case, for some odd reason, for reasons I do not quite understand why, we were able to push through there without, like, any problems. And that is one dead Atlas. And there is more things to shoot at. Now, the one problem I have for this particular setup is that the Jägermech is pretty squishy as far as mechs go. The side torsos and the center torso are large and wide, as you can see from the back of the Jägermech there. This is a very wide and big mech, and those arms are pretty damn weak as well. It is kind of easy to get rid of the guns on this thing by just, you know, shooting the arms off and so forth. Then again, you can just shoot the damn center of this thing and it will sort of die because it is so wide and you can hit it easily enough. Why am I saying that is the problem with the ultra autocannon two belts, and the kind of the same with an autocannon two belts as well, is that it requires you to have essentially unobstructed field of fire to the enemy for quite a long time to truly pour out the damage. Ultra autocannons work a little better over the autocannon variant when it comes to autocannon tools, because you can at least burst fire these things. Hello, there is one of those sort of new thunderbolts. So I am just unloading them here. How did I not lose either of my arms in this fight? I don't know. But this is where I realize I am alone, so I'm just going to suicide here to try and do some damage. Oh yeah, have a scoreboard. Right, moving on to the next drop, which is on Polar Highlands. There is a rumblings of new Polar Highlands coming, and that might actually have happened by the time this video goes live. Possibly? Maybe? Depending on the on when the patch is coming. When the actual patch date is, and if it happens. Because, well, things may go wrong in software development and all sorts of other things, so I am, you know, not holding my breath. You should not either, because something can go completely horrifyingly wrong. But hopefully we can always hope, huh? Anyway, so Polar Highlands, this is the old version, in case you happen to be watching this from the future, where the new Polar Highlands has already landed on us in MechWarrior Online. So, if you look my positioning-wise here, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to give myself that clear line of fire. I'm trying to do that whole support weapon platform here. Please allow me to shoot you for a long time, because that's how I actually need to deal my damage. And, of course, enemies who do that sort of thing, that allows me to pour out the fire. It's an opponent which is not shooting at me. So, my squishy little Jaeger mech is kind of safe. And it is also an opponent who is just, you know, exposing and then being free to be peppered full of Ultra Autocannon 2 bullets. Which is fantastic. That's how it should go. A problem is that it doesn't go often like that. And the other problem with this thing, obviously, is that Bad target selection there for me. Another problem here is that leaning a push of any kind with this thing is kind of a thing. Like here, no shooting at that Rifleman 2 makes a lot of sense. But previously, in that previous moment, I should have started shooting at that Deathstrike instantly, because it's a much more scary target over the Rifleman 2C than it is the scarier target. This is, by the way, why so many light mechs get away with doing a whole lot of things, because people do not perceive them as a threat, but they you know, are fairly big of a threat from certain aspects of the game. However, still, to be honest, let's be honest about that. Which one do you shoot at? The direwolf or the light mech standing next to the direwolf? You shoot the direwolf, because the direwolf is gonna kill you instantly. Well, not instantly, but you get my point. Anyway. This is working sort of nicely. It is the usual NASCAR around the middle, which I hope the new upcoming changed Polar Highlands, and that's a nice skill still. Upcoming Polar Highlands does a little bit away from somehow. Let's see if that happens. But this whole ring around the middle, this thing, yep, this is still happening in this particular polar. And this mech works for this sort of situation fairly well, because those guns are gonna jam on you, and so you need to stop firing from time to time for a bit anyway, because the guns are, you know, you need to wait for them to unjam. There is a bunch of little things to shoot at. This is the point where you hope that people stop actually running. And oh yeah, let's just focus fire something out, right, like that. Just pour fire into it, hope that you get it down. And of course, cool off a little bit here and there. And miss a lot of shots, and that's another kill. Okay. There is another kill. Thankfully, they overheated and decided to stand still, so. But there is the jams coming into the play, and this game is pretty much done, so thank you very much for watching, and of course, get these scoreboards. See you folks next time with more MechWarrior Online.